adventures with Joey Brent or anything.
Boo!
And she's always been unfair for me.
Shut up. Joey, you know why I asked you to come out here for the second half of the show? You know, this is just a little recapping here. You know that Bad Brad has got a lawsuit against ASWF.
Where is Brad?
Hopefully fine.
Unfortunately, again, as I don't know,
where is Brad?
He's not here. He's got a lawsuit, but he's not here.
Two shows in a row.
Exactly. He talked so much crap about ASWF. He's talked so much crap about you, sir. He's talked so much crap about me.
Is he even going to show up on the 28th?
Well, let me ask you something. You know, we've seen on social media where he's been blah, 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 blah. He said, you know, he's been on Facebook. He goes, I could be here tonight. You know, you don't know that or not. And I sit there,
I'm not friends with him on Facebook.
I'm not either. That's why I got back here in the locker room and I got here. And Ricky Rowland, you know, he has an ASWF page, and he's in charge of. Ricky was telling me, informing me, that Brad was going to be here or not. And then when I got here and I got in that locker room, and you had called me down because I was back here searching that locker room, he didn't come back here and he didn't show up.
What? If my son was over there.
But I tell you what, fans, this is why I'm out here. I'm going to waste you more time. I promise you, and I promise you, the next time you see Brad, I don't care. I'm telling you right now, I'm just going to be blunt. I'm just going to put it out here right now, Joey. I'm Joe Jones. I'm telling you right now, this is personal. And I'm looking at you, this is not a wrestling thing. This is not me coming out here being booked on the card. Gary Swift, you listen to me, please. This is law enforcement entertainment, whatever you want to call it. This is real. This is not, I'm not playing. I'm not trying to be, I'm telling you right now. He comes to this locker room, he comes to talk to me. You're going to have to arrest me. I'm telling you, this is personal. I will beat. Because he wants to get personal. He wants to get personal on Facebook and talk about my fans. He wants to talk about me. He wants to talk about my company. I've been here 11 years, Joey. I've been here 11 years, sweat, blood, and tears. And I tell you what, Brad, I tell you what, 16. Put this on the internet page. You're the NFL commissioner. You put your commissionership up. Tell Ricky, put it on the page. Brad, I challenge you to show your ass up here in 2 weeks to ASWF.
Ain't gonna do it.
Thank you,
brother. It's too busy trying to find his sleeve for the 28th.
Just thinking of that. Sleazy, listen up. After I left here, before the second half of the show, Joey, I got three guys. He told me on the phone just a while ago, in two weeks, these three guys will make their presence known to your ASWF. Yes. What are you talking about?
You gotta get it.
There ain't no doubt about it. I'm telling you, 2 weeks, fans, I will build my three guys and I ain't playing around. Next time you see Brad, I promise you 110%, I'm on your side. And next time you see Brad, I'm going to knock him on his ass. And I promise you. What?
There's kids here.
I can't even put my hands on nobody.
Show the team. We can't say that word.
You're right. That word. I'll calm down. But I promise you on his side. Joey.
Oh, you can say it.
Joey. I'm going to go to the back for a minute, calm, get my things together. Remember, tonight's the 10th. And I'm going to promise you, fans, can you understand me what I'm saying? Here's your fans. In 2 weeks, I will bring my guys and reveal them here in 2 weeks. And I'll be here and I will call out your so-called other half commissionership, Bad Brad. Brad, I know you can see me. You've butthole, you chicken, show it. It's time to put up or shut up and reveal you're free. Cause I'm coming for you in 2 weeks.
So I guess that's that, and I'm left all alone at the announcer's table, just like usual. I don't get to ref tonight, don't get to get in the ring. Now I'm back at this table, back where I was 6 months ago. You guys haven't noticed, I've been working out a little bit. I've read a few books, self-help books, if you want me to be honest. I've made a lot of leaps and bounds, and I hope you guys have noticed.
In your head.
Get a buzz on.
But here we go, 2-on-1 handicap match. SWF Heavyweight Championship number one contendership on the line.
What's his name, Sleazy?
Sure.
to do my job. As Curtis John, J.U. Zahn, the pounding of Steve-O.
Does that show up and sitting right at the top?
So if Mark Wolf right now pins Steve-O, what happens to him? Get a title shot?
No, he doesn't get a title shot because he doesn't get the pin. If Curtis John doesn't get the pin, he doesn't get the title shot. If Mark Wolf gets it, he's going to hang him all by himself. I don't know if it's going to be like a one-man show kind of thing.
Right.
An invisible kind of match, but it sounds kind of cool.
Take yourself in. Now you see what I'm saying? Mind games are going to play in here. So double team, and Curtis, what's his name, Curtis Matthew?
Curtis Don.
Curtis Don, don't get a pin here. You know what, he's S.O.L. here.
What the, I get you upset. We have to call him right here. Curtis Don has been here for a while now. He's looking for a break himself. We need to pull the leg tammy straight off the leg of Steve-O. Now he's working on that quadruped sweat and that knee. He's a rocker.
First time right back into that leg, working on Steve-O.
Steve-O really in trouble here. Referee trying to make sure the shoulders are not on the mat.
And this is all represented the last event.
But he's the champion. You can call him a representative, but that doesn't mean he's like somebody in five. He's the champion. He's won the title.
Oh,
meat. I wonder why this referee has a clean cut haircut on the top of his head, but he has a wild beard. You figure if he could get a haircut on the top, he could.
Look, here's Shimo in a lot of pain. Punched on, looking on.
Focus on the match. Focus on the match. Mark moving control here. Steve-O is only seconds away, a three count away. A submission all the way from losing his number one contendership. It's all on the line here at ACWF.
Who's listening to number one contendership?
I'm not saying that he is. I'm not saying that he's not. I feel like you guys are pressuring him.
Well, if Steve-O's going to lose again, the coach John is going to be screwed out. This is Steve over there in a lot of pain. Fans are asking for Steve. Rip on Steve, would you ask for the scene here? Come on. And we're going to get the ESPN fans to find Steve here. The handicap match here for the number one contendership.
This title shot is what he's worked for, and he's not going to give it up that easily.
You're exactly right. What do you mean? I'm eyeballing me like that. I'm just saying, look at the curse on him now. That's the way it should be if you were putting the number one contendership on.
I'm not eyeballing you like a sexual kind of way. Can we just wrap this? Don't think it's like that. It's Steve-O back into the corner. Curtis gone face first into the mat. Mark Wolf back in the ring. Stopping Steve-O.
What's wrong with Mark Wolf here?